Hello there, good morning, God bless you, hallelujah. This is the day the Lord have made that we will rejoice and be glad in it. Like the psalmist said, he said, this is the Lord's doing and it is marvelous in our sight. We give God praise who has made it possible for us to see another wonderful day. Today is the beginning of work day of the week. Today is Monday, and I welcome you to God's word for your week. And I'm trusting God that you are going to receive a push that you need this week prophetically by God's grace, by the power of His Spirit, that this week will become an outstanding week for you and for everyone that is connected to you, that rejoices in your joy, in the mighty name of Jesus. What we do every Monday by this time is that we take time to prepare ourselves in God's word and then in prayer for our week. We pray for the week, we prepare the week to deliver as heaven has planned it to. Praise the Lord. The plan of God is that the scripture says in the book of Proverbs 4 verse 18, it said, the path of the just is a bright shining light that shineth more and more unto the perfect day. The word of God declares, blessed be the Lord our God who daily loads us with his benefit. So in the plan of God, in the agenda of God, God's plan is that daily you will experience progress, weekly you experience progress in every area of your life, and that is why we do this, to help you and to push you in the place of prayer. Praise the Lord. Okay, let's pray. Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, we worship you. We give you praise. We give you glory. Can you just take a moment and appreciate him where you are? Lift up your voice and appreciate him. Jesus, we give you praise. We give you glory. We bless your name. Adonai, we worship you. Adonai, we magnify you. We thank you, King of glory. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you, Lord, for enabling us today to see the beginning of a new week. We say, blessed be your name. Thank you, King of glory. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord, we bless your name. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you glory. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen. Covenant keeping God, there is no one like you. Alpha and Omega, there is no one like you. Covenant keeping God, there is no one like you. You are the Alpha and Omega, there is no one like you. Covenant keeping God, there is no one like you. Alpha and Omega, Omega, there is no one like you. O Lord, covenant keeping God, there is no one like you. Alpha and Omega, there is no one like you. Father, Lord, we thank you. We thank you because there is none like you. Blessed be your name. Thank you, King of glory. We worship and exalt you. Take all the glory, dear Jesus. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Okay, we're going to be looking at what the prophetic word that God is giving us for the week. I'm sharing my screen with you quickly. Thank you, Jesus. We are taking our reading today from the book of Psalms, Psalms 23. Psalm 23, please, if you're watching, let us know where you are watching from. If you are with us, let us know, let us know, let us know. Praise the Lord. Psalm 23 from verse 1, and we're praying with it today. Okay, I have people that are on the line. Glorious Rain Christian Center is on the line. Say, thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord. I have Tammy. Gugela on the line, thank you for joining us, Tammy. Good morning, Pastor Success Azuka and all my brothers and sisters. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I have Pastor Joy Success. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. So any other person, if you're on the line, let us know where you are joining us. Hallelujah. Okay. It's Psalm 23 from verse 1. It said, the Lord. Psalm 23 is a very, very powerful psalm. Very, very powerful psalm. It says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Who we submit our life to has a lot to do with the supply that we enjoy. The person that is in charge of our life is a reflection of the supply that we will enjoy. The Lord is my shepherd. The word the Lord there is the word Adonai, the Lord, Master. Verse 2 says, he make me to lie down in green pasture. He leadeth me beside the still waters. Verse 3 says, he restore my soul. He lead me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. And verse 5, which is our focus, verse 4, is majorly our focus this morning. Say, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. That is what God is saying to you this week. He said, I am with you. Even if you go through the valley of the shadow of death, I am with you. No matter what you go through, I am with you. I am with you. I am with you. I am with you. That is what the Lord will have me say to someone this morning. The Lord is saying to you, I am with you. And you are going out, I am with you. You see, the presence of the Lord, the consciousness of God's presence in our life is the backbone of confidence. The consciousness that God is with me is the secret to daring things in life. If you know that God is with you, what is it that you wouldn't do in life? What is it that you wouldn't dare? If you know that God is with you, going out there, you will not be afraid to go out. If you know that the Lord is with you, you will not be scared to dare to take that step. If you know that the Lord is with you, you will not be afraid to enter that relationship. If you know that the Lord is with you. So God will have me say to you this week, he said, I am with you. Even if you go through the valley of the shadow of death, death will not snatch you this week. Affliction will not take you this week. You will not die because people are dying this week. He said, I am with you, because the presence of God is a healing presence. The presence of God, no evil can thrive in the presence of God. The scripture told us in Psalm 114, it said that when mountains saw the presence of God, the Bible said that mountains skipped like ram. It said when Jordan saw the presence of God, Jordan fled like a lamb. So there is no mountain that can stop the presence of God. There is no demonic force that can stand the presence of God. So God is saying to you this week, my presence will go with you. My presence. You see, all what made the children of Israel different from every other person on the face of the earth was the presence of God. In the book of Exodus, Exodus 33, Moses began to pray and said, Lord, Lord, show me your glory. Lord, if I found grace in your sight, show me your glory. You made a promise that you will go with us. And God said to Moses, he said, because of the stubbornness of the children of Israel, I will not go with you. And Moses said something very, very outstanding. He said, Lord, if you do not go with us, how will we be different from every other people on the face of the earth? How will they know that we are different? So the presence of God is what makes the life of a believer different. What makes the what the atmosphere that a believer carries, what makes the Christian life an outstanding life, is that presence. When that presence is with you, what stop others cannot stop you, what limit others cannot limit you. Some time ago, I read about a man of God that came to South Africa many years ago. His name was called John Gillick. And when John Gillick came to South Africa, there was an outbreak of a pandemic that happened then when he came to South Africa, of a kind of flu then that used to kill people. And before it killed people, it will make people to foam, you know, like people that were having a kind of leprosy kind of a thing. And then they will foam through their mouth and then they will die. And then it was said in the book that I read, in his testimony, that when the people die, before they carry the people, just like what is going on now with coronavirus, they say, no, if you get close to the people, you will contact the virus. And then one day, John Gillick, in the warehouse, they used to isolate the people, and in their warehouse where they kept the people. And then he said he was going there to pray for them. And then they told him, I said, no, you cannot go and pray for them because you will be infected. And he told them, I said, no, I cannot be infected. And then one of the person that, you know, was having the attack was on the floor and the foam was in the person's mouth. And he told the scientist, he said to them, he said, you people should come and check the foam in the person's mouth. So they took a microscope and they checked the foam in the person's mouth. And in that foam, they could see the organisms, you know, the germs that comes with that virus in the foam, the one that was in the person's mouth. And then the man used his hand and then caught the foam, and he told them, test the one in my hand. And by the one time they tested the one that was in his hand, they couldn't find any organism, they couldn't find any germs in it. They were dead. And they asked him and said, what happened? He said, because I carry the presence of God, because I have the life of God in me. If you carry the presence of God and you are conscious of the life of God in you, coronavirus cannot thrive, no matter what variants they call it, no matter whether they say it's called Delta variants, whether they say it's called Delta plus, whatever variants that is, because the presence of God is more potent than vaccine. The presence of God is stronger than any medication. So God will have me say to you, he said, no evil. If I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, he said, I will fear no evil. So the first thing, I was telling somebody yesterday, the first thing that kills people before any evil kills them is fear. So the presence of God, the first thing that it happens is that when the presence of God overwhelms you, the first thing is that it kills fear. Fear dies at the presence of God. Fear dies at the presence of God. Fear dies. I will fear no evil. I will fear no evil. Sometimes what kills people is not the virus itself. What kills people is not what they are going through. It's the fear that associates what they go through. Is that fear? Is that fear? And the scripture says in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7, it says, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but he has given us the spirit of power, of love, and of sound mind. God says, as you are going out this way, go out boldly. I will be with you. Even if you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, death will not swallow you. Evil will not overtake you, because I am with you. I am your God. I am with you. I am your God. So all you need to do is for you to be conscious of that mighty presence. One, think about it. Think about it. You are a son of God. You are a child of God. You carry the spirit of God within you. Think about it. If Jesus were to be on the earth now, do you think that Jesus, is possible for the Lord Jesus to be infected with coronavirus? Just think about it. Think about it. Is it possible for the Lord to be infected with coronavirus? If the answer is no, then No, the same Lord. He is the same one that is living inside of you. When we come to Jesus and we say, Lord Jesus, come into my life, be my Lord and personal Savior, we receive the invisible, the bodiless Jesus in the person of the Holy Ghost inside of you. You can't carry him and carry sickness. You can't carry him and carry coronavirus. You can't carry him and carry disease. No, 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 no. You can't. You can't. The Bible says in Acts chapter 10, verse 38, how God anointed Jesus Christ with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. How he was anointed. Everywhere he went, he healed. Everywhere he stepped into, he did good. So if he is inside you, he will do you good. If he is inside you, he will heal you. If he is inside you, he will deliver you. You see, when he instructed the disciples in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, he said to them, you shall receive the Holy Ghost, you shall receive power after the Holy Spirit is come upon you. He said, you shall be witnesses unto me. First of all, he said, in Judea. Judea means from your house. Judea means from your family. So if the Lord is in you, his work begins first inside of you. You are his Judea. It begins in your body first. Carry that consciousness. And I want you to know there is a God that preserves. So if he's inside of you, be conscious of that. That was the secret of the patriarchs. That was the secret of Joseph. When Joseph was in the house of Potiphar, Joseph carried this mindset and said, I know I am a child of God, and everything he did prospered. I know that God is with me. God with a man is what makes the person outstanding. God with a man is the extra that is on top of your natural. That is what is called the supernatural, extraordinary. So you must be conscious about that. I cannot die like a normal man. I cannot die like an unbeliever. I cannot be stopped like an ordinary man because I am extraordinary. I am extraordinary. You must be conscious of it. It's the consciousness of it that awakens the power. It's the consciousness of it that activates the power to walk in us. Even if I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. This morning, I just want you to imagine God saying to you, I am with you. I am with you. I am with you. I am with you. Okoha, I am with you. Helen, I am with you. Joy, I am with you. Priscilla, I am with you. Just imagine God saying that to you. I am with you. I am with you. He said, thou art. I am with you, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. They comfort me. They comfort me. And it is the consciousness of this that will make you weak to become outstanding. Outstanding. It is this consciousness that causes the next verse to manifest, verse 5. It said, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. The enemies are there. The challenges are there. Yes. God does not deny it. He said, thou anoint my head with oil and my cup runneth over. In the face of that challenges, God will stood you up. He will stand you up this week. In the face of those problems, God will give you a testimony. In the face of your enemies, God will cause you to be outstanding this week. In the mighty name of Jesus, I will prepare a table. I'll prepare a table. And my prayer for you this week is that the Lord will direct your step. He will guide you into that table he has prepared for you. In the name of Jesus, you will not miss what belongs to you this week. Your step shall be divinely ordered and divinely guided. In the mighty name of Jesus. And verse 6 says, surely goodness and mercy, goodness and mercy, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Not some days, not few days, all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord. I shall dwell. I will hear your testimony this week. In the mighty name of Jesus. You will not fall because people are falling. You will not be destroyed because men are being destroyed. in the name of Jesus. He said, 1,000 shall fall on my left, 10,000 on my right, and it shall not come near my dwelling. Only with my ears shall I hear the reward of the wicked. That is your portion. You, your family, those that are connected to you, that rejoice in your joy, your children, your husband, everyone that you hold sacred around you. This week, you are preserved in the mighty name of Jesus. And we are going to pray. From verse 1 said, the Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. You are going to say, Lord, this week, Lord. Now, let me tell you, I want to share this in the church. There are four animals that the Bible use in the description of the life of a believer. Four different kind of animals. The first one is the lion. The Bible describes the Christian life as the lion. The second one is the lamb. He describes us as the lamb. The third one is the eagle. He describes the Christian life like the eagle. And the fourth one is the sheep. And among all, the sheep is the only animal that have no defensive mechanism. Every animal that God has created, he didn't say ram, he didn't say goat, he said the sheep. Every animal has a defensive mechanism. Somehow, even the chicken, if the chicken has chicks, and then you want to, if it's a very wild chicken, and you want to pick any of the chicks, it can peck you with the pick. A sheep does not have a defensive mechanism. It doesn't have horn. A real sheep, that it doesn't have horn. Sheep is not wild in nature. And God knows. That is why in this place, he used the word shepherd, because you are his sheep. He know that there are battles of your life you can't fight by yourself. He know that in you as a person, like the Bible says in Jeremiah 10:23, I know that is in me as a man is not what it takes for me to direct myself. So that is why. So all you need to do to enjoy this divine direction and his provision and leading is, number one, for you to acknowledge that, Lord, I cannot defend myself. Number two, for you to yield totally to him and say, Lord, lead me and guide me in all I will do. That's all that is required. That's all that is required. So we are going to pray this morning. Lord, this morning you are my shepherd. Lead me, Lord. Guide me this week in the name of Jesus. He said that when he guide you, he will make you to lie down. He will make you. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He said he will make me. Not that you make yourself. That is where you have to yield to him. He will make me to lie down. Not that I will make myself to lie down. You have to yield yourself. So you're going to say, Lord, I commit my week into your hand. I yield to you this week, Lord. I place a demand that you lead me, Lord. Guide me in the name of Jesus. Say, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I commit my week. I yield myself this week to you. My Father, guide me. My Father, lead me in the name of Jesus. This week, lead me. This week, guide me. In all that I will do, in the mighty name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Lord, lead me. Lord, guide me in my business. Lord, lead me. Guide me, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. In all that I will do this week, Lord. Lord, you are my Lord. Adonai, lead me. Adonai, guide me. In the name of Jesus, Father, lead us. Lord, guide us. Lord, lead us, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. He said, lead us not into temptation, Lord. Lord, this week, do not allow me to walk into the trap of the wicked. Do not allow me to walk into temptation. In the name of Jesus, do not allow me to walk into the trap of the enemy. Lead me this week. Guide me this week. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Verse 3 says, he restored my soul. He lead me on the path of righteousness. He restore my soul. He lead me on the path of righteousness. Lord, this week, Lord, restore me. Whatever that I lost, whatever I ought to got last week, I didn't get. Whatever I ought to get this month, I've not gotten. Lord, restore me this week. In the name of Jesus, as I embark on my assignment this week, my Father, restore me in the name of Jesus. Say, my Father, oh God of restoration, I pray, Lord, visit me this week. Restore me this week in the name of Jesus. Visit me this week. Restore me, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus. Lead me on the path of righteousness. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. My Father, in the name of Jesus, Libaro Jalagadash, Lebrande Katoko Bragadaba, Libaro Jadande Garus, Ekrine Fande Kasuziaza, Vares Ekrinazos, Kalonde Barazekata. Lead me, Lord, guide me in the mighty name of Jesus. Lead me on the path of peace. Guide me on the path of increase in the name of Jesus. Lead me, my Father. Thank you, King of glory, in the name of Jesus. Verse 4 says, yea, even if I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. He said, because thou art with me. You're going to consciously place a demand on divine presence today. Divine presence. You see, all that Moses carried in Egypt was divine presence. God was so much with Moses, a man that was a fugitive, that was a wanted man. But when he came into the Egypt with the presence of God, he could not be arrested. He shouted the name of Pharaoh. Nobody could stop him. Father, I place a demand on your presence with me today. Lord, as I go into the week, Father, go with me. In the name of Jesus, as I go in my business, into my business place, Lord, go with me. In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, accompany me. In the name of Jesus, say, my Father, my Father. My Father, my Maker, I place a demand on your divine presence upon my life this week. Go with me, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Walk with me this week. In the name of Jesus, go with me. Walk with me. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. My Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, walk with me this week. In the name of Jesus, walk with me. Go with me. As I go into my week, go with me. As I go into my week, walk with me in the name of Jesus. As I go into my business, Lord, go with me in the name of Jesus. Go with me, go with me, go with me, my Father. Go with me, my Lord. Go with me, Jesus. Go with me in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, King of glory. Go with me, Lord. Blessed be your name in the name of Jesus. Verse 5 says, he prepares a table before me. He prepares a table before me. He prepares a table before me. A prepared blessing. He prepares a table for me, a prepared blessing in the presence of my enemy. Lord, whatever you have prepared for me for this week, Lord, Lord, let it locate me. Whatever you see in heaven, God, everywhere there's an allocation with your name. There is a blessing with your name. Every week, every day. Psalm 68, verse 19. It says, blessed be the Lord our God, who daily loads us with his benefit. Blessed. It says, blessed be the Lord our God, that daily, there is a daily packet for you. There is a daily blessing for you. So you're going to pray, Lord, the blessing that you have prepared for me for the week, Lord, I receive it in the name of Jesus. Blessed be the Lord who daily loads us with benefit, even the God of our salvation. Lord, the package blessing, prepared blessing you have for me this week, I receive it in the name of Jesus. Say, my Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, the prepared blessing that you have for me this week, I receive it. I call it forth. Angels of the Lord, go before me. Angels of the Lord, go with me. I call for my blessing. I call for my favor in the name of Jesus. Whatever allocation of blessing heaven has for me this week, I receive it in the name of Jesus. I receive it in the name of Jesus. I decree I am walking in the favor of the Lord. My steps are directed by the Lord in the name of Jesus. My steps are ordered in the name of Jesus. I am favored this day. My helpers are locating me in the name of Jesus. Lord, anyone you have commanded to be a blessing to me this week, Father, Lord, place my name upon their heart. Place my burden upon their thoughts. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray.
Kezuzala dabadash. Rakwana kande baragizo linde katos. Lifrede goru shaladaya. Lipeketo zinda garu shalanatas. Let my thought be upon the heart of my helpers. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let my thought be upon the heart of my helpers. In my place of work, the prepared blessing. I receive it in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your name. In the name of Jesus. And he says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me. Surely goodness and mercy. Lord, I place a demand on your goodness and your mercy for my week. I place a demand on your goodness and your mercy for my week. In the name of Jesus, let your mercy go before me. Let your goodness accompany me. In the name of Jesus, let your mercy go before me. Let your goodness accompany me. Say, my Father, in the name of Jesus, as I pray, Lord, this week, let your goodness go before me. Let your mercy accompany me. Let your mercy go before me. Let your goodness accompany me. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. My Father, in the name of Jesus, let your mercy go before me. Let your goodness accompany me as I go into my week. In the name of Jesus, as I go into my week. In the name of Jesus, as I go into my week. Let your mercy go before me. Let your goodness accompany me. In the name of Jesus, surround me with your goodness. Surround me with your mercy. Show me your goodness this week. In the name of Jesus, show me your mercy, your goodness. Livarusha la nekato baradash, ekwande garush, ekride gabaladash, baro jalana kates, lebrakato kobaladaba. Your goodness, your goodness, your goodness. Take away pain, take away sorrow, take away disappointment from my week. In the name of Jesus, take it away, my Father. In the name of Jesus, let your goodness. Thank you, King of Glory. Blessed be your name. In the name of Jesus, we are going to take authority. John chapter 10, verse 10. He said, the devil cometh not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. We are going to use South Africa as a point of contact. South Africa need your prayer. There is a release of violence, a demonic force of violence over South Africa. For the past 3-4 days, there have been destruction. They are destroying things. Violence is on. They are looting businesses, burning cars on the road. We're going to pray. We arrest the spirit of violence. We come against satanic possession that take hold of the heart of men. You see, one thing is that when people's mind has been perverted, they do not listen to the sense of reasoning. You cannot correct wrong by doing evil. If you have issue with the government, take it out with the government. You can't have issue with the government. You are attacking people's business. You are looting shops. You are attacking foreigners' shops. You are looting citizen shops. You are looting malls. That is criminality. That is the devil. That still, we are going to take authority over that force of hell. In the name of Jesus, we take authority over you. Satan, you can't steal from me this week. In the name of Jesus, you can't steal from me this week. We rebuke you in the name of Jesus. We pray for Africa. We pray for South Africa. We rebuke the demon of violence. In the name of Jesus, we rebuke you. We rebuke you. We rebuke you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. In the name of Jesus, we come against the spirit of violence. In the name of Jesus, in South Africa, we arrest you. We use South Africa as a point of contact to other nations. In the name of Jesus, Father, we pray for South Africa. We pray for South Africa. We decree peace in the land. We decree peace in the land. We decree, Satan, you can't steal from us this week. We come against the demon of destruction. In the name of Jesus, we arrest you. We chase you back to hell. In the name of Jesus, we chase you back to hell. In the name of Jesus, we chase you back to hell. In the name of Jesus, you demon walking, taking possession of the heart of men, we rebuke you. We rebuke you in the name of the Lord Jesus. We speak peace over the land. We speak peace over the land. We decree you can't steal from us this week. You can't destroy our businesses. You can't destroy our shops. You can't destroy our street. You can't destroy our land in the name of Jesus. You can't destroy our families. We arrest you in the name of Jesus. The hand of the Lord is against you. The hand of the Lord, we speak peace. We arrest the unrest in the land. We arrest the unrest in the land in the name of Jesus. Oh God of heaven, he said the kingdom of this world has become the kingdom of our God and his Christ. In the name of Jesus, we come against you demonic force of violence. We arrest you in the name of Jesus. We arrest you. We speak peace. 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 We speak peace in the name of Jesus. In all the province of South Africa, we declare peace. We declare calmness in KwaZulu-Natal, in Gauteng, in Johannesburg, in all the province, in the name of Jesus, in Ladysmith. We decree peace in the name of Jesus, in Pretoria. We decree peace in the name of Jesus. We decree peace, 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 peace. He said, the God of peace shall bruise the head of Satan. Father, Lord, we thank you. Jesus, we arrest the situation. Holy Spirit, step in. Step in. Step in and give us peace in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We plead the blood of Jesus over the land. We plead the blood of Jesus over the land. We release angels to preserve lives. We release angels to preserve businesses in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. Jesus, we give you praise. And I speak over your week. I decree your week is blessed in the name of Jesus. You are going out is blessed. You are coming in is blessed. I speak into your week prophetically in the name of Jesus. I decree every step you take this week shall bring result to you. Every desire of your heart this week, your righteous desires shall be granted by the hand of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, what you could not achieve before, go and achieve it this week. Go and achieve it this week. In the name of Jesus, men and women will remember you. Favor will knock on your door. You are sick. I command you to be healed. In the name of Jesus, death is far away from you. Evil is far away from you. Sorrow is far away from you. I decree you are preserved. You are preserved. You are preserved. In the name of Jesus, your week is blessed. 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 Your family is blessed. In the name of Jesus, your children are blessed. The blessings of the Lord overtake you. In the name of Jesus, this week you will receive good news. You will receive a phone call that will change your life. I speak increase in your storehouse, in your bank account. Let there be supernatural alert. In the name of Jesus, you will receive increase. I speak peace upon your home. In the name of Jesus, restoration, 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 restoration. In the name of Jesus, go forth. I will hear your testimony in Jesus' precious name. It is well with you. It is well with you. Send me your testimony because I know surely you will have testimony this week. Send me your testimony. Send me how this program is blessing your life. Share the link. If you have not shared, share the link. You are watching on YouTube, give us a thumbs up. If you have not subscribed, subscribe. Please subscribe to the YouTube. That's the way you encourage us that what we are doing is blessing you. Share it to your family members. Encourage your family members to follow us on Facebook and also on YouTube. God bless you. I will see you at the end on Wednesday. I'll be live on Wednesday, the same time you are watching me now, for Upper Room Prayer, Upper Room Prayer Encounter, and on Friday by 6 p.m. for Hour of Restoration. I will see you, and God bless you in the name of Jesus. Have a most blessed week ahead of you. Go in this dynamite. Do not be afraid of anything. In Nigeria, we say, nothing shaking.
you will see the end of the week, and not just that you will see it, you will see it with the blessing of the Lord in Jesus' name. God bless you.